Hold on, let me just turn on my air conditioner. That is quiet after all. But, this movie. No set, by the way, but, yeah, I enjoyed it. This is going to be pretty spoilery. I just want to let you know, because the movie is still pretty new, so. And it's like, you know, it's not, I mean, Space Jam A New Legacy was still pretty big. But not, you know, it's not like your superhero movie where it's a little bit bigger than, you know, your more, like, I mean, the 2021 Mortal Kombat wasn't really, you know, hyped. But for some reason, why is every movie that's released to HBO Max? I think Warner Brothers did, like, an agreement with HBO Max because all these, like, that they're going to be like, okay, anything released by us in this year is going to go to straight to HBO Max and theaters. And that works. But they've been making, like, two-hour movies. Even Space Jam A New Legacy is still, like, an hour and 55 minutes. Which, it's not 2 hours, per se. But it's still, kind of like, 10 minutes, 15 minutes-ish away from being 2 hours. So, that's still, like, you know, not, like, oh, that's short. Like, you know. There are, you could watch something that's like an hour and a half. That's shorter than an hour and 55 minutes. But, anyway, I digress. So, essentially, this movie has a weasel in it that is a disgusting CGI creature. And it dies, but it's not dead. Anyway, essentially, follows a group of people that essentially have a thing implanted in them, I think you know. And it's very similar to the Belko experiment. There's, I think, a reference to it when someone tries to stab the lady with the pen. Maybe a reference, like, the panel is kind of the same, where it will make your head explode. This movie kind of reminds me of Freaky, with, like, Christopher Landon's burst to Freaky. He said, we aren't going for a PG-13 type of gore. We're going into R. We're really leaning into that R. And that's what I was thinking throughout. It's definitely not like your type of more, you know, kid-oriented type of movie. It's definitely not meant for kids. I mean, it is, but it isn't. It's meant for, like, a little bit more mature audiences as, like, literally, even gunshots are still pretty brutal. But, like, there's people getting, like, someone literally has, like, it's literally just their chest and, like, their organs are still sticking out and some of them are on the ground. It's definitely meant to be R, that's it. It's definitely an R-rated superhero. Which, I mean, that's great. There are not that many R-rated superheroes. Like, there is Deadpool and all that in there. But, I mean, I want to see more violent type of superhero movies. And they definitely did, like, get... It was definitely violent. There was a little bit too much CGI, in my opinion. But... could be budgetary reasons. Could be studio reasoning. They probably had a bunch of money to just chuck away, and they didn't really want to spend it on practical effects. And, I mean, here's the thing. You have to pay a few people to do it, or you can pay more people, but it will look worse. And I think practical effects are better. But, I mean, Harley Quinn does, like, do a throat slit, and that looks kind of cool, and they really like it. It kind of looks practical, and it's bloody. Like... this movie, I a little bit too long for my opinion, but I mean, it definitely isn't really a horror movie. I'm sorry, you guys can kill me now, But here's the thing, I like my superhero movies. Okay, don't come at me for covering superhero movies. I may do like Venom and Venom 2, but this isn't going to be something that happens all the time. I am going to do Ghostbusters Afterlife. That's also something kind of horror. I mean, it's a PG, it's about ghosts. Technically, ghosts are horror. It's also a comedy. I don't know if, I mean, it features one of the kids from Stranger Things. So, do you really fight with that? You don't. Okay, I'm gonna do Ghostbusters. Because that's something I really like. I liked that since I was pretty young. I loved Ghostbusters since I was young. Anyway, I'm not here to talk about Ghostbusters. Can you say I do the baby? Maybe I see Ghostbusters 2, you know, that the dude who's like being possessed by the painting and he just, can you say I do the baby?
Hello, baby!
It's the best life of that movie. Anyway! There's giant eye creatures that are like facehuggers, but then they turn you into zombies, and then are being controlled by a giant eye starfish thing that literally like goes like this, and then a bunch of things pop out of its armpit. Kind of weird, I gonna lie, but yeah, this movie is meant to be a standalone thing, not involving the 2016 one or the original. Apparently there are multiple. I thought the 2016 one was, you know, the original. But apparently there was an even older one. I didn't know about that. That's something I didn't know. So, hey, thanks, Dad, for teaching me that. But this movie doesn't feature Joker, which maybe for better or for worse. That's not my opinion, but it definitely is violent. I mean, it's a superhero movie, so I don't know what I'm gonna review it with. Like, you kind of have to form your own opinion, but it's okay. It's not bad. It's a little long. It has some pretty stupid humor, but I kind of liked it. I laughed a lot. But here's the thing. James Gunn made Guardians of the Galaxy and Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, which those are two separate universes, but they, you know, like, I'm not saying both the movies are separate universes. Like, there's the Marvel Universe and the DC Universe. What if there was a crossover? That would be amazing. You would probably make a bunch of money. Maybe take, like, you know, the Jason versus Freddy format and literally make that into a movie and give there be at least a solid half hour. Maybe even towards the end, maybe in the beginning of Spider-Man versus Batman or Polka Dot Man, who is in the thumbnail because he's one of my favorites. I mean, he throws polka dots. I think he, like, sometimes swells up if he doesn't throw them twice a day. That's cool. Like, the effect, it looks like it's swollen and, oh. And there's even, like, a little bit of neon in there. Oh, that looks so cool. I really thought that was good. I don't know about you. You have to form your own opinion here. Get HBO Max for Wonder Woman 1984. That movie was pretty bad, and that was 2 hours long. That was pain. The Roblox event wasn't even that good either. That's always been there here.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time I bet there's rich folks eating from a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. If they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle